the end of the day, you're another day older. And that's all you can say for the life of the poor. It's a struggle, it's a war, and there's nothing that anyone's giving. But one day you're standing about, what is it for? One day less to be living. At the end of the day, there's another day's dawning. And the sun in the morning is waiting to rise. And the waves crash on the sand like a storm that will break any second. The higher of the thunder, the rain is on the rain. It's gonna be hard to play. At the end of the day,
I directed Les Mis 13 years ago now when I first arrived at school. Scary proposition. I was quite naive. I'd done quite a lot of shows, but nothing on this scale. And I recognised that we made a lot of mistakes, so I thought it would be a good idea to revisit it and try and correct all those mistakes, which I think we have.
I think this is a really professional production, and that's what Giggleswick aims to deliver. It's not a school play. It is at a school, but it is professional standards.
At the end of the day, it's another day over. With enough in your pocket to last for a week. In a land of in a shop, keep on crafting as long as you're able. Keep on crafting, keep on crafting, it's gonna be hard on the table. It's gonna be hard to pay.
My character is Jean Valjean.
And who's that?
He's a convict from the chain gang and he was put in jail for 19 years. The most important thing my character does, there's two, it's taking on Cosette as his daughter, or it's for realising that when she grows up, it's for realising that she needs to understand what Valjean did in the past, like what happened, his story, because she doesn't know until the very end of the play.
I'm Fontaine, and she was a factory worker, but then she gets fired and she has to go into prostitution and sell her body to save her child who she's having to send money to. It's really meaty, I have a fight.
Here's something new, I think I'll give it a try.
And I get my hair pulled, and then it's just good fun.
The usual price for just one slice of your pie.
I don't want you! No, monsieur, let me go!
Is this a trick? I won't pay more.
No, not at all.
You've got some nerve, you little whore. You've got some gall.
I had it free, my life would be.
And everyone cries by the end because it's like a beautiful song.
So different from this hell I'm living. Different now from what it seemed. Now life has killed.
My character is Javert, Inspector Javert. Everyone thinks he's the villain, but he's more of an anti-hero in the sense that he does what he believes to be right. That's why he kills himself when he finds out that he's been wrong for like 40 years. In a couple of productions I've done like the good character or the textbook one. I'm quite happy to be doing something that's a bit more villainous or misunderstood or a bit more complex. I like it, it's nice.
On my own, pretending he's beside me. All alone, I walk with him till morning. Without him, I feel his arms around me. And when I lose my way, I close my eyes and he has found me.
So I'm playing Eponine, and she is basically in love with Marius, who's one of the main boy parts. Eponine is still trying to fall in love with him and get his attention all the time. And because she's so obsessed with him, she actually like changes into a boy so she can go fight at the barricade to be closer to him, and then gets killed because she wanted to be so close to him, and she never gets forever.
My character is called Marius, and he's one of the revolutionaries who's really good friends with Onyolas and helps them through all the revolution. He also falls in love with a girl called Cosette, who is the girl who's adopted by Valjean, and he completely is madly in love with her. And his story is basically deciding whether he stays with his friends or he goes with her.
A ghost, you say? A ghost, maybe. She was just like a ghost to me. 1 minute there, then she was gone.
So my character, Cosette, really it's just her life cycle of not knowing what life is about because she hasn't been able to experience it because she's been so trapped, especially from Jean Valjean. And so when she meets Marius, it's just like a new world to her. She doesn't understand relationships. The only relationship she's had is with, well, her so-called father. And so with meeting Marius, it's all a bit confusing. She doesn't know what to like think about it.
One of the issues that we face is the venue in which we work. I'm working alongside Sally, it's been fantastic, because she's tried to fix some of those problems. The issue of time and place, because this is a play that constantly shifts time and place. So we had to find a way of resolving that issue by creating some sort of composite set, which could be used to suggest locations and help define shifts in time and place through lighting.
Luckily, Mr. Offland can read music, and some very key music moments, he can create some amazing lighting changes that really, really add to the whole feel of the transition, the flow of the piece.
Look down, don't look him in the eye. Look down, you're here until you die. The sun, he's strong, he's hot as hell below. Look down, there's 20 years to go.
We didn't want it to be glaringly panto. We wanted to have a period authenticity.
Realistic.
Yeah,
which involved a lot of distressing, making them look, the costumes look like they've had a history. So I wanted everyone, from the principals down to the ensemble members, to have their own individual costumes. I didn't want a whole bunch of people to have all the same skirt or all the same top. I wanted them to have a sense of their own character, even if their role was quite a small one. My favourite costume, as a group, I would have to say the lovely ladies. I mean, as I said, I wanted to give them a sense of history, so I looked back at earlier fashions and had this whole sort of backstory about their costumes, and I wanted them to, like, they bought their costume from the Rag and Bone Man, and the Rag and Bone Man bought it from a second-hand shop, and they bought it from a maid, and the maid got it from the aristocrat.
Lovely ladies! Lovely, lovely little girls! Lovely ladies! Lovely little ladies! Lovely girlies! Lovely little girls! We are lovely, lovely girls! Lovely ladies! What a lady for!
It's an absolute marvel to see Sally at work, because there are 592
costume and accessory items in total. I mean, that's everything. That's shoes, hats, gloves, coats. I think possibly we've added a few more since I did that calculation.
The concept of making a new costume, hand sewing manufacturing something beautiful and then messing it up, attacking it with a cheese grater, rolling around in, at one point Miss Silverman is rolling around
in
Fuller's
Earth.
Do you hear the people sing, sing the song of angry men? It is the music of the people who will not be slaves again. When the beating of your heart echoes the beating of the drums, there is a life about to start with tomorrow comes. And even down to, you know, the students and anyone who was capable, they have been told that they can't have their hair cut, and they've tried to grow beards, some very successfully.
I'm only allowed a beard for the musical.
Javert, the military people, had sideburns to cover up scarring from musket shots.
So the opening scene, I'm in the prison, and they're not allowed to shave because they're like, kept in such horrible conditions.
It's part of the character to have this monstrosity, so I've managed to grow one.
The impact visually when you see those costumes in situ is what makes it such a spectacle. It's when you put together the costume with the design, with the lighting, that the magic of theatre happens.
Tomorrow we'll discover what our God in heaven has in store. One more dawn, one more day.
Music is just more emotive than speaking. The very last song where everyone's back on stage and singing together, I think, is definitely one of those two. Because it involves the whole cast, so everyone's really going for it and everyone's just so like passionate about it.
Yeah, it's been a pretty good experience because it's my first drama, really, big drama thing at gig school, so it's been great fun.
It's Les Mis. It's one of the most amazing plays, and I think we have a really good cast as well.
It's the fact that it's quite an ensemble piece.
There's that level of passion in there from the people who are passionate about it.
It's really full on, like lots of rehearsals, lots of lines to learn.
And then also remembering where you have to go, which place you have to enter from, which song you're actually singing.
Yeah. The talent that we have on show is immense.
There's no one really there who's just stood deadpan. Everyone's really into it, having fun.
The production is basically made up of a lot of younger students. The majority is actually year 11 and below.
And they're coping really, really well. I mean, some of them haven't even acted before. They're doing a really good job.
There's some very promising and talented people on the rise.
You get to meet everyone in school, the community improves, and as well, everyone gets a chance to do it.
Yeah. It goes from year 9s to opposite, and it shows like a whole kind of like community.
That's a cracking word.
I've made a lot of new friends who I wouldn't have spoken to if I hadn't done this.
If you do well on stage, that's great, so does everyone else. You meet people, that's how you succeed.
You get the skills to be able to sing and act through singing.
It's confidence.
Yeah.
It's all about confidence.
Because obviously it's quite a vulnerable thing to be on stage in front of everyone.
I'll be sad when it's over, definitely.
Yeah.
Because it's taken up so much of my time.
It's a once in a lifetime opportunity, I think, to go and see it. Because it's so expensive at the West End.
Many other people have said that our particular production is better than many West End shows that they've seen.
It's better than the West End.